Okay, so this is just a quick video about something that's really interesting in the wetlands here on my property. And this is because just a few days ago we had a break in the weather and the bees were flying and they were getting lots of pollen from somewhere. And I was wondering about that because most of our trees are not blooming, there aren't flowers for them. So what's the first pollen source going to be? They had this pale yellow to almost white pollen on their hind legs. So on the wetlands on my property, I decided to go and hunt out something in particular. In this part of the country, northeastern United States, we have a native plant known as skunk cabbage. And it's only found in wetlands. Again, this is on my property. And I decided to hike out here, even though it's only 30 degrees right now and it's been really cold and it's windy. I'm going to find these skunk cabbage and share some details about it. There's one right there. So you see that little burgundy colored spike that's sticking up through the damp there among the moss? That is the beginnings of the skunk cabbage. And inside that is a little pollen source. There's a little flower in there. And there's some interesting facts about this. Notice that this thing is open just a little bit. Honeybees that fly out on early spring days like this, well, it's not spring yet, it's March 16th to be exact, they fly out and they really are in jeopardy because it's often very cold and they try to get resources and come right back to the hive. Well, do you know what the skunk cabbage offers that a lot of plants don't? Heat. That's right. These little things generate heat. Enough so that this plant, as it emerges through the soil, could actually, with the aid of heat that it generates on its own, melt right through ice and make a tunnel through snow. And then it's called skunk cabbage because it puts off an odor that smells stinky, like a skunk, like rotting meat, things like that. I don't think the smell's that bad myself, but if you look at this little opening here, you can start to see the pollen inside there. Now I'm trying to find one that generates heat because what I'm carrying with me today is a thermal camera, and I want to see if it's true. These things really generate their own heat. So we know it's 30 degrees, 31, 32, and I'm going to pull this FLIR camera out here and look at that. See the light spot around the base of this skunk cabbage there? 42.4 degrees. And if you look at the scale on the right there, it drops all the way down 29, 28, so the areas adjacent to that are as low as in the 20s, 27.6. And this thing is up to 43, 44 degrees. That is amazing. So how does it help the plant? Other than getting through snow and ice and help it to emerge in the spring, this provides an area where pollinators like honeybees, they're enticed by the scent and then they locate these plants in the wetland areas, and there are miles of wetlands where I live. And you look inside here, once the bee goes in, it's rewarded with a warm environment while it collects the pollen. So it can increase its own body heat, get restored a little bit, be sheltered from the wind, and then hopefully fly back to the hive. But look what else is in there too. Spider webs. So other spiders and flies and other insects are also in here. And the spider wants to catch those insects when they go. So, but this is a close-up, so you can see this thing is covered in pollen. So this is a really fascinating time. In the past, you know, I've always known about skunk cabbage. I've always seen it, you know, through the wetland areas, especially when it's mature and big green leaves there that are often eaten by black bears, which we have plenty of. But I was actually unaware all these years that these things generate heat and that the pollen was sheltered in this way. Just look at the way it's all wrapped up and warm and cozy inside. So all the bee has to do is make it through that opening, and then it can gather pollen at its leisure, no matter how cold it is outside. But my bees generally won't fly unless it's in the high 40s, low 50s. And this is going to be a critical pollen source for my bees. Nothing else is open, as I mentioned before. There's going to be lots of tree pollen coming along. But when the weather warms back up, they're going to be right back in here in the wetlands getting in these skunk cabbage. And then I just, you know, look at the configuration of it. It's very interesting to look at. So that's the information I wanted to share. We were kind of speculating, what is that light pollen on the hind legs of those bees? And we know that skunk cabbage is available, but we didn't expect it to be so early. Again, it's only March the 16th. St. Patrick's Day is tomorrow. And this stuff will come through ice and snow, and it's amazing. So there are a lot of people that eat. It's a rhizome. So I'm told that black bears will dig it out. It grows in the water and the humus areas of wetlands. And it's everywhere. So for my bees, they don't have to go very far to find it. Although, you know, within a mile of where I live, we have a fairly large river zone watershed area. And look at this one. The floral part is almost purple itself, or a little pinkish there. And then you see the yellow highlights that are very pale. That explains that pale pollen that's on those bees. Interesting stuff. And I can't wait to come back out on the next warm day. Today, none of the bees are flying. But I'm definitely going to pay attention to these plants. When we get a warm up and the honeybees are headed back out, this shows what our weather situation is. Not great. So let's hope it warms up soon. Thanks for watching. I hope you benefited from this detail about a very fascinating native plant in northeastern United States.